possibly use some of those dollars to build the two trailheads. Nice, you know, roads, parking, and then mark the trail. A lot of the trails are already there, they just need to be marked.
But you need a parking area, you're talking about this being a trailhead right here. So we'd have to do parking and handicap or whatever up in this area here, probably restrooms or whatever, I mean, even porta johns. And then the other one's gonna be on Seven Millie. So, right, so it would be on the acres that we don't give away or sell or whatever we're doing, there would be a access point off of Duck Lake Road into the conservatory.
Yeah, yeah, we would be partnering just for that 19 acres, not the whole Russell.
Yeah, for that access point, yep.
That's not the way I understand it.
No, it's partnering.
It's partnering the whole thing.
Sounds good to me.
I mean, I'm not exactly sure how this has worked out contractually, but in general, yes, I mean, I think the understanding is that if the Nature Conservancy forks over 300 grand to the township, for, you know, for the created natural area, it's gonna be incumbent on the township morally or legally or both, you know, to develop the property for uses that are compatible with the terms of the conservation easement.
Correct. Correct.
If they choose to develop it, they would have to do it in such a way that's consonant with the terms of the conservation easement. Whether the township can just take the money and run Venezuela, I'm not sure, but that's not come up. I mean, you know, that the legal niceties, you know, that are involved in what the township is or is not compelled to do as a result of this deal, I don't know. I haven't heard any discussion of that. We've only had discussions about possibilities. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
we've gotten a lot of information from the public about how they see this piece of property fitting in with people's plans, you know, to make use of it. So what people would want to do there and what they would not want to do. But we went through a couple of exercises, including a public charrette, you know, and got some pretty detailed information from people about what they thought would work and not work, and where trailheads should be, that's where, and where trails should be. And the public, you know, saw this area next to the fire barn and the site up on Simon Alley where there's already, you know, a kind of a two-track, as being suitable locations for the trailheads. And then, am I getting this right?
So I guess we have two different resolutions here, or motions. One is, do we partner with the township on the conservatory?
Or do we walk away and leave it in their hands on it?
Right.
And then secondly, do we give the land away?
Right. So, my thought is I'm in favor of partnering.
You're in favor of
partnering.
I agree.
Yeah. Well, we don't own the land, so we can't sell it to anybody. Right.
Right. But this would, as a partner, and what the limitations or the expanse of our partnership would be are yet completely undefined.
Yeah, at least we'd have a voice.
At least we'd have a voice. The township would be more than happy to say, you guys handle it, and they dump the whole thing to us, and frankly, we don't want that. I don't believe we do.
And this is just for that 19 acres?
No, this is partnering.
The partnership involves the entire chunk.
The entire 300 acres.
So what's the issue about the 19 acres?
That's just giving away two of the acres
for the fire department. Well, then I guess I'd like to make a motion that we partner with the township on the Land Conservancy.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? to the selling of or dividing up of the 19.2 acres that is now currently Duck Lake Grove Park, to allow the township to take two of those acres, which is the elimination of Duck Lake Grove Park as we know it now.
It's the elimination of the park, or just the reduction from 19 acres to 17 acres?
It would be both, because the 2 acres encompasses the park. The park is part of that. So that would potentially be theirs to do with what they lease.
The 2 acres.
Yes.
The 2 acres will do whatever
including
they can
the park.
Do. Including that portion of the park. The other 17 acres is still considered Duck Lake Road Park, but what it is just property.
The 2 developed acres where there's some sort of life going on, so to speak.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I guess what I call that is the Duck Lake Road proper.
2 acres.
Mm-hmm.
Motion to walk away or keep it.
Yeah.
So in other words, when the township sells the building, they'll also be able to give them the 2 acres.
Correct.
Which is currently
And what we're agreeing is the motion would be to allow them to give that up to the White Lake Fire Authority.
Regardless of what the result is going to be.
Exactly.
All right.
I second that motion.
Were you thinking this partnership agreement? Because I'm finding myself wondering who it was that approved the clear cutting of that 19.2 acres, or the part of it that's behind the fire barn.
That's a good question. I don't have
that
information.
Is ugly, isn't it?
That's real ugly back there.
Nobody here was around at the time that decision was made.
I was here, but I don't recall. I know there was a forester of some sort that went back there, but I don't recall their name.
Yeah, so that the commission apparently was not consulted about that part.
So I make the motion that we
offer. No, I'm sorry. I just, you know,
no,
you understand what I'm saying.
Of course.
That we don't want to get railroaded into something that we might not approve otherwise.
Well, before I make the motion, I guess I like the opportunity. There are pros and cons to both, and I'm on the fence here. Part of me is I don't want to give something up that could have some benefit, that maybe with a few dollars could be improved, but it isn't getting any use. There's one. Two is I like the idea. This is where the plus side of it for me is the fact that the White Lake Fire Authority will have the opportunity to expand that building if they need to and bring more equipment that is a direct benefit to the residents of Fruitland Township. Should they have emergencies, they'll be better equipped to handle those emergencies. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's a little bit of give and take.
Good for the greater number argument is, you know,
exactly.
That's your main thing.
Right. The other thing that, you know, it's one less park under our supervision. It's one step closer to not having a parks commission.
Well, you're fishing in an uphill stream at that point. So
yeah, it's true. It's true.
We'll cross that bridge when we literally get to that bridge.
But there is a bridge.
Right.
Even if we have to build it.
Okay. Then I make the motion that we allow the 2 acres of Duck Lake Road Park be part of the fire station possible purchase.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Okay. Disc golf card or park registration.
Yeah, I think you all saw the exchange of email where I tried to clarify what I probably didn't make very clear in the first place is that I had what I had in mind was a sign up rather than a registration, a mandatory registration. What I had in mind was voluntary sign up where people accessing the park, you know, would have an opportunity to, you know, sign in, and depending on how we want to handle it, we could either gather information about them or not, but at least give them, you know, the opportunity to provide us with some feedback about their experience in the park. Ultimately, as far as the disc golf course is concerned, I'd kind of like to know going forward how many people are using it and where they're coming from.
I, after the last discussion, I was kind of for it, and then I turned my head the other way a little bit. I've always liked the idea of being able to gather information about or from individuals that are utilizing township resources and find out where they're coming from, what they want. Individuals that would sign up, become a registered Eastern Park, I mean, you've got to make it appealing to them. There's got to be some benefit to it. You know, we'd like you to register to be a friend of Eastern Park. I mean, that's just something I'm throwing out there. And then what are the benefits of being a member or a friend of Eastern Park? What's the big benefit? Why? I mean, I'm going to look at it as an individual that they want me to sign up. They want me to register to come in here to use the... First, they're going to say, well, I got to register to use the park.
And no, that wasn't my idea. My idea was...
No, but that's the question that they're going to have. You know, and then... Other things may be, well, why do I register? What's it, what good is it going to do me? What's my benefit? Am I going to get notified of, you know, events or things that are happening at the park? Or, you know, what's the benefit?
Well, we'd have to put a few sales hooks in there when we made the sign, I guess. You know, please help us understand, you know, your experience at the park. And one of you silver-tongued individuals with a lot of business experience come up with something.
You know, and Mary maybe might be able to correct me on this, but how many of this panel here sign up and get the Fruitland Township e-newsletter? Okay, we all do. Last census, and I'm